So you fell in love at 9. When was the first time you drove something in anger? Race car, not street car.
Not snowmobile.
I don't know. I was probably my first couple go-kart races whenever I was running second, and I wasn't winning, so I got pretty angry about that. So I don't know. It was quite often, honestly. So
one of the memories of Unser Jr. at the Speedway that is forever ingrained in my memory is when Emo took him out and he got out of the car and just got on the side of the track and gave Emo the thumbs up, and I'll never understand the presence of mind that you had to do something other than give him the thumbs up. I know that I wouldn't have had that restraint. Imagine that. But can you tell us about that emotion?
Well, honestly, what happened that day? You know, I was upset, obviously, because we were coming around to get the white flag, and we were faster than Emerson, and. We didn't show it until the end of the race, and so you know, we went in there and it was just traffic that slowed us down, that allowed Emerson to get beside me, and there were several things. It was illegal to run below the white line in that particular year, and so Emerson he was just going for the win. I mean, Emerson Fittipaldi is a wonderful man. He wouldn't hurt anybody. And, you know, he's the one that when accidents happen, he goes out to the circuit and so on. And so I knew Emerson, it was just racing at that time. And so we crashed and got off to the side there, and I got out of the car and everything was fine. And I started to walk out to the track, and one of the safety crewmen, he stepped in front of me and he said, "Where are you going?" And I said, "I'm going out there." And he goes, "Well, what, you want to flip him off?" And I went, duh, yeah. Like I was going, "What are you thinking?" So he said, he stepped aside, "Go right ahead." And so I went, "Okay." And so I got out there, and there was just a moment of clarity. Honest to God, I was waiting for Emerson to come around, and you're standing. It's like standing in the middle of a football stadium full of people, and I was just surrounded by people, and so on, and so I thought everybody's expecting me to. Give him the finger, you know, which I wanted to do really bad, and it was just a moment of clarity of you know, that Emerson had led most of the day. He had run strong all day long, and so you know, it was just one of those things that I wasn't gonna get the win. It was gone. Kind of thing, and so I just thought about, you know, giving him thumbs up and you know, congratulating him on that win. So that's what we did.
I'm sure Virgil would have loved to have heard you say that you asked yourself, "What would Jesus have done?" So. I think that's, you know, unbelievably classy move, and it's a microcosm of the type of person this gentleman is. So thank you very much for joining us, and it's really been a pleasure.
I did want to say a little bit more about that 89 race. We got in the ambulance and went back to the hospital. My dad comes walking in the hospital, And I'm sitting there, he says to me, he goes, "You can win this thing." And I kind of look at him, I go, like, "What?" And he goes, "You can win this thing. Emerson was below the white line when he passed you, and that's illegal." And I kind of looked at my dad, and I go, "Dad, he's the one drinking the milk, you know? I mean, he's the one in victory lane." And my dad really looked at me like, "You're crazy," you know, kind of thing. But I didn't want to win it in a courtroom or nothing like that. And a lot of where that really comes from is my dad won the race 4 times, and I never went to victory lane with my father. In 70 and 71, I have 2 older sisters, and in 70 and 71, we were too young to go to the race. In 1978, his 3rd victory, the 3 kids were on our way to go to the race, except I decided to ditch school a week in a row, 5 days in a row of my dad being back at Indy, and so I decided I wasn't going to go to school, so I got caught. And so my sisters got to go to the 78 race, and lo and behold, my dad wins the race, which I was so thankful that he won the race, because if he didn't, I don't think I would be alive today. He literally told me that when he got home. And so I was racing sprint cars. It was my first season of sprint car racing, and I was grounded from the sprint car, which really hurt bad, and that was no fun. And then in 87, when my dad won his 4th one, I finished 4th in the race that day. And so I never went to Victor Lane, and so that was where I was wanting to get on my own really bad, and so it finally came in 1992, and that was an exciting race, which is still the closest finish in history today, so it's something we're very proud of. So yeah, thank you.
So one last short story. One of the best quotes I ever heard Allenser Sr. talk about on television. Somebody was asking him about his son and how great his son is doing and how did he get that good. And your dad said on television, "Well, of course he's good. I taught him everything that he knows. Luckily, I didn't teach him everything that I know."
That's right.